guys, what is up? It is Century. How you doing? Today's gonna be a part due to one of my most popular videos here on my channel, why you personally, yes you, should change your eyebrow shape to better flatter your face. This video is part of an ongoing series on my channel where we ditch the Instagram trends that you are probably so used to seeing on social media. Contours, lip shapes, eye shapes, all of that is customizable with makeup, and that is the point of this series. So if that sounds interesting to you, feel free to subscribe down below. We would love to have you. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for joining me on this little video journey. It means the world. I'm very excited about today's video because, unlike last time where I just explored a couple different brow shapes, in this video I want to do celebrity brows. And this video is also sponsored by Casetify featuring Pokemon, so I'll talk about that a little bit later in the video, but for now let's go ahead and get into it. Hi. Also, I'm sorry if the lighting in this video is really tragic. Very foggy today. Anyway, the first celebrity that I want to tackle is Zendaya. Her brows are super, super, super full. Occasionally a little bit more unruly than other times, but for the most part, they're pretty structured. So what I'm gonna do first is take this tiny little eyebrow brush here and the Browsings Pro Palette from Benefit Cosmetics, and I'm actually gonna take the lightest shade up here along with a little bit of the wax, and I'm gonna start filling in the shape that I want. The big difference here is that with the Instabrow, you would, one, be filling in much more deliberately and sharply, and also with a much darker color. Here, I just kind of want the hint of hair, the illusion of hair, in the spots that I am dragging this pigment. Also, if my brows look really weird, or if you see little, they almost look like burn marks, I shaved my brows the other day. I hadn't done it in a while. I was really out of practice. You win some, you lose some. Zendaya also has a bit of an arch, so I'm gonna brush all of my brow hairs up, and then instead of trying to conceal out an arch underneath my brow, I'm actually going to take those same light colors, extend the top of my brow. Now this looks crazy. So what I do next is I take that same brush, but this time wet so that it can be more precise and a much darker color, and I am just going to fill in little fake hairs. You can do this with a number of different tools. I'm using a brush because it happens to be the closest. I really like the Urban Decay Brow Pen, also the MAC Brow Pen. I really like the Kush Brow Pen from Milk Makeup. Then I'm gonna go ahead and do a couple flicks in the front, actually facing towards the inside of my face. Again, keeping the color pretty light. And last but not least, I am gonna take a little bit of concealer right here. I tinted my brows the other day. I did it the same day I shaved them, and maybe I should have separated those two actions. I both tinted and bleached my brows before, and y'all, I forgot how much of a difference brow tinting makes. If you are dissatisfied with the thickness of your brows and you're jealous of other people's brow juiciness as I am, try tinting them with beard dye. You can also go and pay to get them tinted, but you can 100% do it for yourself for like $7, $5. I think her brows are a slight bit more unruly, at least in my reference picture. Use a clear brow gel to gel everything up, leaving a couple little hairs above that brow line. And y'all, I think for this one, that's about as good as we're gonna get. You know, to be completely honest, I wasn't feeling it at the beginning, but based on the reference photo, they're pretty similar. The next brow style I want to try out is Doja Cat, but before that, let's talk about today's video sponsor, Casetify. So if you've somehow never heard of Casetify before, they are, of course, a phone case company. But what makes them different from competitors is that they offer military-grade drop protection as well as being really freaking cute. And on top of that, they do collaborations, like I already mentioned, with some of my favorite artists and franchises. They've done collaborations with like the Rolling Stones and freaking BTS. They have BTS phone cases, as well as my personal favorite, which obviously, duh, has to be their Pokemon phone cases. I just think these are so freaking cute. The fact that Gengar, best boy, has his little number down there and everything. These two, this one which is customized and this one which is of course also customized, both of them to say snitch. This one is so cute. If you want to check them out and see their other collaborations, literally, I can't even describe to you how varied these phone cases are. You can find a little bit of everything. You can go to casetify.com/snitchery and we can match. I've never worked with a phone case company before because I've never felt like one of them really stood apart, but I do think these are so fun and I was so impressed with the quality that I had to let you guys know about them. Okay, let's get into some brows. Now, our girl Doja. Doja has some really interesting brows. They start pretty unruly at the front and then taper off to be very, very, very thin at the end and pretty much straight across. I don't know if I'll be able to achieve that with my natural brow shape that I've got going on right now, but I'm gonna do my best, all right? So what I'm gonna do first is take that clear brow gel and actually just spike the hair in the front to begin with. And then before even adding pigment, I'm gonna gel the rest of my hair into the shape that I'm going for. Also, if you see any like patchiness right here especially, that's just from the tint. I think her eyebrows are just thinner than mine. I have sparse brows in the sense that they don't have much thickness of hair. Like, I don't have a lot of hair in my brows, but they're very wide. Now I'm gonna take this brow pencil and just start filling in the tail portion. I'm using a pencil because I tend to like how a pencil looks a little bit better over brow gel. And then for the tail, I found that with a pencil, if you want a precise line, you do kind of have to pull your skin a little bit, dart a line straight across. Now in a perfect world, my brow tail would end right here and the Doja brow would kind of taper off to about here, but that's not our reality. And if there's one thing I've learned this year, there's no reason to stress over things we can't control. Take my concealer and just thin out my brow a little bit. Just to make it look a little bit straighter across, I'm gonna go in with a brow pencil and try to straighten out right underneath this arch and also extend that line. And y'all, there we go, two looks down. We have the Zendaya brow on the right here. This is obviously very bold. I feel like this kind of gives you the Instabrow look if that's what you're going for. If you want a thick, bold brow to frame your face, if you're wearing a very glam look, if you're going to an event or something like that and you want a brow that's gonna stand out, but you don't want it to look really blocky, I think this is a good alternative because obviously using that lighter powder, you can still see my individual brow hairs, so it's not gonna look as caked on and inauthentic maybe. And then on this side we have the Doja brow, which is much sleeker, much smaller. I hope this sort of modified version that I did here with my own natural arch to my brow can help you guys achieve a very similar look if you want that sort of cute elfy brow style, but you don't want to commit to shaving off the tails. You can also just draw a line across and extend past your natural brow line to create that straight across brow with makeup. I'm gonna go ahead and take off Doja. Next is the Megan Fox brow. Now, some might say I do have an obsession with Megan Fox, and they would be correct. This look, I'm gonna go into the Maybelline Color Tattoo brow pomade. Actually, this might be an eyeshadow. It is an eyeshadow, but it's just a black pomade, essentially. Wipe off the excess on the rim, and then I'm gonna start drawing a line on the lower half of my brows, extending that line past where my brow actually sits. That will help extend the illusion of a really high arch if you don't actually have a high arch in your brow, bringing both the front and now the back of your brow a little bit further down than they naturally go. You can see here, helps the middle look a little bit higher. And then I'm gonna start working product in from the bottom up. I don't wanna put a ton of product all over my brow because just like with the last look, my brow's a little bit thicker this way. I'm just really exaggerating that shape. I'm gonna create a couple little flicks right here in the front. And I'm gonna take a spoolie and just spoolie that black color up towards the top of my brow. And then for this brow especially, it is the most important to gel your hairs down, especially these bad boys. These will ruin your plans every single time. Make sure if you have wider brows like me, gel everything to the side instead of straight up. I think that's the closest we're gonna get with this one. This is my biggest fail. This is my flop era. I think honestly this brow shape is just so different from my natural brows, though I have been saying like a year now, and I still think it's true, coronavirus put a monkey wrench in the universe's plan to bring back these super skinny, super arched brow. Mark my words, she is coming. Last but certainly not least is Ariana Grande. Now, Ariana Grande has really interesting brows. I actually love them on her face, but if you look at her brows without the rest of her face as the context, they're very short, they're very wide. They're kind of unusual, but they look so good on her, so I've been wanting to try it for a while. I'm gonna take another brown, this time even lighter. Honestly, my brows are just gonna be way too long. Like, hers should stop like right here. Lately, I've really been enjoying the technique of filling in my brows like this by dusting back and forth rather than just stroking. I feel like it gives a very natural, diffused effect. You know, to be honest, Ariana's brows actually look very similar to the Korean-inspired brows I did in my last brow video, which were much easier to achieve back then because I had no brow hair. Then using a slightly darker brown, I'm gonna go ahead and even out the bottom, especially this area right here, my arch. And then I'm gonna spoolie out all of that color. eyebrows right now are nearly black since I just tinted them, so having them be super light would actually be pretty tough for me probably. I'm just gonna take a little bit of face powder, tap my spoolie. This won't make a huge difference, but it will kind of help soften up that dark color. And then if you wanna really, really lighten them up, you can go ahead and take a little bit of concealer and with a very gentle hand, just lightly run that through your brows. Obviously, as you can see, you can get pretty light. And if you overdo it, just take the other end of the spoolie and diffuse that color. And y'all, I think with my brow shape and my brow hair color, that's about as close to the Ari brow as we're gonna get. But again, compared to the first brow look we did, versus this one, it changes the look of my face entirely. And that's all I have for you guys today. Let me know what you want to see me do next. I think it would be really fun to do a part two to the lip video or the eye video, doing the same thing that I did here and trying to recreate celebrity styles. I'd appreciate it if you liked the video. If you liked it, thank you so much to Casetify for sponsoring this video. If you made it to the end, leave a ghost emoji down in the comments, and I will see you guys in the next one. Mwah. Bye, guys.